Hello, site owners, man here with the BlogAid Live Tips Tuesday and breaking news. We've got some news on Yoast SEO, a new thing that they came out with that I had checked with Yoast himself about some of the settings and whatever, and it's for June 23rd, 2020. We got a lot to talk about. It's been a cray-cray kind of week, so we got all kinds of things to talk about. Let's jump in. If you're watching this anywhere other than the BlogAid Facebook page, that's where the whole party is. If you're watching on YouTube, you just get a little snippet of it. You can also watch the replay over here, but I hope you'll come join us live. We do this every Tuesday night, and more information is in there too. Hey, Marilyn, good to see you here. And if you're here, say hey. Let's go ahead and jump in. So Yoast has come out with it. Yoast, every time they do an update, it's on Tuesday. I never have the opportunity to put it in Tips Tuesday, and usually I don't mention it or whatever, but this one was breaking news because I went cray-cray over it. They've got a new link attribute, and I'm going to show that to everybody in a little bit because it's a little confusing how it's labeled. It's about sponsored and no follow, and I'll show everybody that after we get through what else is going on. So I've got a new guide for you on the Google Core Web Vitals, what you need to know and do. This is not something you can wait on, folks. Because fixing the issues that it comes with, it takes a lot longer than doing like an HTTPS conversion. Everybody waited to the last minute and I was booked up to heaven with those. These take a lot longer to fix. You do not want to wait. I'm going to get booked up to the sky again. And the new Core Web Vitals tutorial that's coming to the DIY SEO course because Google Search Console has a new tab for that. And we're going to put the village to work on that too. And why you can't wait to jump on this, I'll tell you more about that in here. And then an update on my theme speed test for Astra, Genesis, and Divi. Woo, I finished it. I'll have it out to the public later this week. And then an upcoming speed test for Elementor. Because of what I found in this speed test, I want to show you even more about Elementor. And then why it's way cheaper to just contact me at the get-go if you need a new site set up than it is to do a site on it and fix things later. And the new Nexus Edge CDN from Liquid Web, you know, name hero, their boxes come from Liquid Web. That's who manages them. Liquid Web, it's the top of the top of the top in the business for server farms. And I'm going to check and see if this CDN is any better than Cloudflare. I doubt it, but I want to give them a fair shake and test. I don't think anything in the world beats Cloudflare for just the sheer size of it. It's the biggest CDN in the world. And plus, it has way more security. Now, why you need to pay attention to the new WordPress minimum requirement for the PHP level at your host. They just changed what the minimum is and why you need to know about this and what you need to do about it. And then why so many content marketers are jumping on Keen. Have you heard about this? I'm jumping on it. You probably need to jump it on too, but there is a catch. You knew there'd be one. It's from Google, so there is a caveat. So you do need to jump on it, though. And what we'll be doing about the native XML sitemap generator that is coming in WordPress 5.5 that's due out in August. And I want to go ahead and give you a heads up about what's going on with that. And then there was an interesting post from Genesis on the future of building with WordPress and Genesis. And, you know, Genesis Pro, which is the new framework, is totally different from the framework that we're using now. And you're going to want to know what's going on with this because it's all about Gutenberg Phase 2 that's coming toward the end of the year. And I'll talk more about why it's coming at the end of the year and why that's not a good idea and why it'll be this time next year before it's ready and what you need to do if you're making changes and why it's time for you to switch to the Gutenberg Editor now and why it's past time for designers to get up with Gutenberg. You're already a year to two behind with this, and the demand is high. So that's what I've got for you this week. Come on over to Tips Tuesday and read more about it, but really come on over to the party with us on Tuesday evenings, and I'll see you online.